Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Today we are talking about columns in ARCHICAD. So when it comes to creating columns in ARCHICAD, well, it's fairly easy and straightforward to create a regular column. Generally, we create our buildings with 90 degree corners. They're pretty easy. But when it comes to creating buildings without 90 degree corners, you'll see the way how you can do that. So let's jump to ARCHICAD. Here we are in ARCHICAD and we are going to test out ARCHICAD columns. At the first example, I presume that we have a corner with 90 degrees. We are going to use a very basic wall for that. You can just hold Shift key in order to make a straight line. But I think there is a problem for this. With the scale, I'm gonna change the working units to centimeter. We click OK and go to Wall tool again and adjust the true wall thickness. There we go, this is the first step, we have created a 90 degree corner. Now it's time to place a column for this corner. In order to make that, we are going to use this column icon. After that, we are going to adjust the sizes. If you want to use different dimensions, you can just use this unlink dimension icon. And column origin can be changed with this icon. I'm gonna use this corner. There we go. If you want to change this icon shape, you can open up this menu and here we have symbol type crosshair and change to X or any other icon as you want. After doing that, if you want to change the structure filling, you can use one of those or create any type you want. I prefer using this concrete reinforced. Here we have our column with some fill. If you want to input further more options, you can use this settings icon. Shortcut is Ctrl plus T. For the column height, we can link the top to story 1. Thus, if we change the story height, the column height will be also changed. Let's try this. In order to change the story height, we are going to right click the stories, go to story settings, and here we have the dimensions to change. For example, I'm gonna make this 100. And we will see that the column height was also changed. If you want to make undo, if you hit Ctrl plus Z, you will be mistaken. The story changings can't be undo with Ctrl plus Z. So we have to use story settings again. We have our first example. Now I'm gonna show you something different. But before that, please let me reduce this length of the walls. As you can see, if you can't do anything with your objects in ARCHICAD, you can try to turn on the suspend group option. There we go, we have done it. And we are going to duplicate to right side. You can make this with a shortcut with Ctrl Shift D. Alright, first one was very easy, but second one will be a little different. What it happens if we change the dimension with a smaller degrees, like so, how will you make a column to this corner? It's not a real challenge. You will see it's pretty much easy in ARCHICAD. First of all, we go to column tool again. Go to structure and you will see we have a couple of options here. At the basic setup, if we just insert our column, it won't work for us. We still have got an unwanted corner. Therefore, we are going to get rid of this. How we can achieve this, I'm gonna show you. Let's just select those, hit Ctrl plus C or copy, because we are going to use those as reference. And we go to complex profile and go to Profile Manager and click New. We are going to input a name here, for example, column. Let's click OK. And here we have Profile Manager window and its settings. In this window, we can paste our copied walls. Center of the current view, zoom to paste it. Okay, it doesn't make sense. And you will see that if you click those are not walls, they are now fills and lines. With those fills and lines, we are going to fulfill our column profile shape. In this reason, we have copied that strategical corner. Alright, when we have this, we are going to use fill type again and we are going to decide our column material. And now you can sketch it out in this window. For instance, we can presume that we have a column part here and with the creation method, we are going to use this one. and this part will be 45. There you go. Once we have this, we are going to create second part. I want to create this with the split element tool. With this split tool, we can split elements apart like so. Or instead of that, you can just use undo and you can stretch your element with these editing points. There we go, we have created our column and now we have get rid of the unnecessary ball parts. Once we have this, we are going to click our column and what you want to see in the floor plan as a border, you are going to use this contour pens. For instance, I want to see red corners around my column. Once we have decided your options in this window, we are going to select this as a core and you click use with column and hit the save. Alright, we have created our column profile and now we can go to column and go to column option, structure and click this icon as a profile option. We are going to use column 1 and place. There we go, we have created our trapezoidal column. With this column, if you want to change the symbol location, you can go back to column option. You can select your column profile and determine the center of the edge and align to the origin point. And also you can make the same for other edges. Once you have that, you will realize that our symbol will be appeared at the center point of the column profile. If we go back to the floor plan, we will change the location of our column, thus the symbol location will be also changed. Alright, we have done our second example. With all of those in the 3D window, you can of course change your column specialties in the 3D window also. For instance, you can change the slant angle. But this was a simple column, but you will see that we can give some slant angle to our profile column too. In addition to that, if you click this point, you can make stretch, change height, you can also change slant angle and also slant target, and with that you can create interesting structures. Alright, if you see that, now we can make undo and go to next step. So let's go back to the floor plan again. And in the floor plan, I'm gonna duplicate this column. And in the structure, you will see rectangle, circular, and profile. In addition to that, you can give veneer to your columns, but not to your complex profile column. You will make that in the profile manager. I have tutorials for this. You can watch them from my other video tutorials. But now, we continue. In this column segment tab, you can see the single or multi option. With this multi options, you can make much more interesting column designs. You are going to use this add icon and you're gonna add segment with that, and with that you can select them one by one and change their option, their heights, thickness and much more. You can give them percent too. With percent, you won't have to input all of the lengths one by one. Is going to determine its own length according to your full extent of your column. You can also determine of the shape of your column if it's going to be straight or tapered. With tapered, you can change top or bottom of the column separately. Maybe I can give this 60 or 50, but instead of that, I can change those and with that I can make more tapered shape. After that, I can select second part from this window and I can continue with the same dimensions. This part will be completely straight and the last part can be symmetrical of the bottom part. And we click OK. You are going to see something strange. Why this happened? Because we have changed the reference points of the column. If we go back to the 3D window, we will see our strange column and click that. In order to fix that, we are going to change our reference axis of core to the center. Once we have changed that, we will realize that if we click our column, we can change the slope angle between in the intersected parts. And also, if you click the reference line, you can add more segments to your column. As you can in the curtain wall panels, you can also use edit options for all of the complex profiled columns. With this improved edit option, you can easily customize your column segments. Those changes will be also visible in the column settings window. Do whatever is convenient for you. All settings are valid for this column as in other columns. Therefore, I'm not going to introduce them one by one. You can add slope, change heights, change story height, etc., etc. Alright, here we are in the last and more exciting part of the tutorial. Together, we are going to create a column example. But this is not going to be a real column. I'm gonna use this all of the options and all of the settings for a custom model. This is going to be a garden wall pillar. And at the very first, we are going to create a base for that. As for the thickness, I'm going to input here 40, as well as this one. But before passing to second structure, I'm going to change the structure type of the first one, structure element, to stone finish, or maybe we can give that a brick finish. You can also use this override surfaces. And second structural element height will be 5 cm fixed, and dimensions will be higher as 5 cm more, and I'm gonna change its appearance. And as for the final step, this structure part will be also changed, but it's going to be a lamp. Yes, we are going to create a lamp with column creating tool. Of course, we can use too much workarounds in ARCHICAD. With this part, I'm gonna input 2 cm or maybe 5 cm. Well, I'm gonna make this with eyeball. Diameter will be 15 cm and material will be aluminum. Once we decided the shape, we are going to duplicate this. In order to duplicate, we are going to select our structure and click add. Like so. Above those, you will see your duplicated structure element. I'm going to give this a glass material. And override surfaces will be a lamp material. As you can see, I'm changing all of the model parts surfaces because when it comes to taking rendering of your projects, you will be able to change your materials in your rendering software separately. There we go, we have nearly done. Let's just click OK and look at what we have in the 3D window. And this is what we get. Alright, I'm very happy with the way this turned out. We have created a very nice parametric garden wall pillar with its own lamp, which you can duplicate along your walls or splines. And splines can be created under Document Window tab. And you can place very easy with just a few clicks. And with that spline, now we can duplicate along whole of the spline with Ctrl plus U and click that pick pad before input, rotate to pad, hit OK. Click the spline, make some offset and follow the shape. And there we go. Well, this was the funny part of the tutorial. Alright guys, this was all it for this video tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed and learned something new. If so, I'm going to be very happy with you. By the way, you can support the channel by hitting the like and being subscribed. And also, you can check out my Patreon page. In my Patreon page, you can download my project files and also my other ARCHICAD tutorials. Alright, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. By the way, I want to give my special thanks to my Patreon supporters.